When a church's finances are tight, it's possible to deplete cash balances relating to operating funds. At this point, a church may be tempted to borrow from donor-restricted net assets. But should a church really do this? Well, first, let's define net assets with donor restrictions. They are simply funds that are being held by the church that were restricted by the giver and have not been used yet. These gifts may be restricted for a period of time or for a specific purpose. It's also important to understand the difference between net assets with donor restrictions and board-designated net assets. Only donors can restrict gifts, and on the other hand, a church's governing board can designate net assets without restrictions for a particular use, such as to fund a new campus or for future maintenance on a building, and they may also later reverse the board designation. But boards cannot unrestrict donor-restricted gifts without the consent of the giver because, again, only givers can restrict or unrestrict a gift. So back to our question, should a church borrow donor-restricted net assets to cover operating expenses? Well, churches are legally required to spend giver-restricted gifts to further the intent and purposes expressed by the giver. Therefore, loans from these funds should be avoided. In some states, borrowing donor-restricted funds for operations is prohibited. And when not prohibited, state laws generally require that the church would demonstrate that a loan is prudent. If the loan is simply to fund operating shortfalls or to avoid reflecting the church's financial difficulties, the church's board will generally have trouble demonstrating that borrowing giver-restricted funds is prudent. Although loans from net assets with restrictions should be avoided, a church that does borrow from them should clearly reflect the borrowing in the financial statements that are provided to the board. The board should also adopt appropriate policies to ensure that the funds are repaid within a short period of time. Well, that about wraps up this short video. For more information on donor-restricted gifts, please check out ECFA's ebook, The 10 Essentials of Giver-Restricted Gifts to Churches at ecfa.church, as well as a related article, Borrowing Restricted Net Assets in the ECFA Knowledge Center. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more finance, governance, and fundraising news and insights for your church or ministry.